नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल एंड कॉपी टू ऑल। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी कवरिंग अबाउट सीएस एग्जीक्यूटिव सिलेबस कवरेज। आई होप यू ऑल आर अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट टू मॉड्यूल्स, मॉड्यूल वन फोर सब्जेक्ट्स, मॉड्यूल टू थ्री सब्जेक्ट्स आउट ऑफ टोटल सेवन। Three of them are MCQs and four of them are theoretical. So let's talk subject by subject. For my own purposes or for making sure that you do not miss any relevant point for you, I will be referring to my few of my notes that I've written alongside. So cost and management accounting being an MCQ exam, it's relatively easier, especially when you are appearing after BCom or IPCC. Still, for those who haven't covered it at all, I think modules should be sufficient. Past question papers, December 14 onwards, because it was then that this MCQ exam was introduced. You may also refer to MCQ question bank by some author like Taxman, but it depends on how comfortable you are with subject. In case you haven't covered it, you may go for it. Otherwise, it's all easier. Now coming to tax laws and practices, with the introduction of GST, there has been a little amendment. The 30 marks IDT, indirect tax portion, has been replaced by goods and services tax. You may refer to amendment update by ICSI for that matter. So 70 marks is direct tax. There has been no change in that. And with respect to 30, there is IDT. Again, if you have covered it in your BCom or IPCC, it's relatively easier. Otherwise, I would advise to you to stick with module as it covers the subject in a very fine and illustrative manner. I would advise you to focus on theoretical concepts, theoretical chapters like returns or assessment, because certain theory questions are also asked in the exams. It's an MCQ exam, to be clear. For those who have given IPCC, few chapters like international taxation, GAAR, general NDA avoidance rules, these chapters are relatively new, so you may give a better focus on them. Giving a clue, this also forms a part of CS final or the CS professional exam, so I would advise you to take this subject bit sincerely, not only because it's a part of CS final curriculum, but also tax as a whole or as a matter is important for us otherwise. Coming to the third exam, ILGL, Industrial Labour and General Laws, this is a part of module 2, but it's generally third in the serial number of the exams. There are so many acts, instead of advising for any other book, I would advise you to stick to the module. Make relevant notes for each of the act, the important points. So there's a space in ahead of each chapter in the module, there's a blank page, you can refer to that. Also focus on the past papers December 14 onwards, because all three MCQ exams were introduced then. Also, depending on how comfortable you are, you can approach MCQ book by Taxman or any other author for that matter. Now coming to company law, the most crucial, the most important of all the subjects. So it's not possible to cover this subject exclusively from one book, but I would still advise that do not take module as a primary source because it's too comprehensive. So you may refer to C.S. Anup Jain or let's say Siddharth Agarwal or Sangeet Kedia. Take their book, take it as a primary. For the leftover topics that aren't there in the book, just give a plain reading from the module. Presentation is the key in this subject. Paper is practical. Have a look at question papers before preparing for this subject, because you need not simply remember the provisions, you should also know how to apply it. So keep questioning, ye provision kyun hai, ye provision kaise hai. So you should, while preparing for the subject, keep an inquisitive mind rather than simply learning section 4 contains this, section 5 contains this. This isn't the approach. You need to apply it in a different circumstances. So go through different question papers, have a view ki kaise question pucha jata hai, and accordingly prepare for it. Do not overemphasize on few initial chapters like introduction type of companies. They are relatively easier, but the newer ones like meetings, directors, so give due emphasis on them. Coming to ECL, the last subject in the module 1, economic commercial laws, there's a bifurcation between economic and commercial laws. You may refer to scanner to see which of the chapters are important and which topics amongst the chapters are important. So it serves two purposes. And also, I would won't advise you to stick to the module as per se. You may refer to one primary book that could be Sangeet Kedia, C.S. Anupjain. Depending on the locality you are or depending on which books your friends are pursuing, I personally preferred Sangeet Kedia for this subject. Also, I used to have an overview of the module so that I do not leave any topic untraced, because I should have an idea at least. And there are certain gray boxes on the module. I would advise you to focus on them because they have been asked in the exam prior. Now, coming to company accounts and auditing practices, generally I see students not focusing on this subject. Rather, I take this subject as the reason for those who dislike accounts, and then instead of pursuing CA, they pursue this course, company secretary, and they do not focus much on this subject. But believe me, I have talked to a lot many guys who aren't pursuing CA as such, but they are pursuing CS exclusively, and they also realize that yes, they did not give due importance to the subject. This is very practical subject and very, very, very scoring, guys, if you give a due emphasis on it. And generally, the bifurcation is 70 is focused on company accounts and 30 marks are focused on audit. For audit, I'll advise you to also to refer to the practice manual in case you have covered BCom, in case you have covered the subject in BCom or IPCC. In case you are new to the subject, modules should be sufficient, plus practice manual for revision. And for accounts, illustrations are quite good in the module. Go through them and prepare it well and practice it too, because sometimes the question paper is lengthy and students don't complete the exam on time. Now, coming to the last, capital securities and market law. This is very, very, very interesting subject. One of the reasons why I advise those students who have pursued IPCC to take up CS executive is because of the new laws that you end up learning about. So again, the approach is similar to ECL, economic commercial laws. Refer one primary book, be it Sangeet Kedia, be it Anupjain. Refer to scanner to know which of the chapters are important and which topic amongst the chapters are important to have a clue, because it makes sense to focus first on them. You can't do anything and everything. So first focus on the important things, and then for the remaining ones, you can have a read. In case a question is asked from them, you can easily answer it too. I would summarize this video in the sense, first of all, guys, focus on scanner to know which of the chapters are important, which topics amongst the chapters are important, so that once you are preparing it, you give due emphasis to those topics that require attention. Do not overemphasize on each topic. And I would, at the same breath, I would also advise you not to overemphasize on scanners. Scanner is simply the past examinations. The future examinations may not be completely based on them, right? So it's just a guide. It's not a primary source. And make notes, because unlike IPCC or unlike BCom exams, you won't have much holidays. Exams would be every day, except one day, there would be a Sunday and you'll get a holiday. So either make your own notes, or on the book that you are referring, make notes by a pencil or a marker, so that revision becomes easier for you. It's very difficult to revise a whole subject in a half day. It's not a matter to be scared of. It's a matter of a challenge. Take it in a positive spirit and nail it. We would be following certain other concepts, like how to write MCQ exams, how to prepare for presentation for different theoretical subjects. In case you have some any specific query with respect to this video or any other topic you want to be covered in this video, you can write to us at wingsoffiresrcc@gmail.com. This is a student-to-student assistance initiative, because we believe in together we learn, and we believe if anything is achieved by one, it can be achieved by everyone. So keep rocking, all the best.